Good afternoon. Welcome to our Eucharistic celebration. In respect for the liturgy and those around you, please silence your phones at this time. Offertory baskets will be available at the designated exits for you to place your contributions. The second collection will be for retirement fund for religious. We ask that you pay close attention to the directions of our ushers, as they will be your guides throughout the Mass, during communion, and at the end of Mass. The flow of traffic at all Masses has been revised to maintain safe social distancing. You'll receive Holy Communion only in your hand. The use of a personal hand sanitizer by parishioners by parishioners before receiving the Holy Eucharist is highly recommended. Everyone attending Mass today is asked to join the communion procession by lining up for communion to receive the Holy Eucharist or a blessing. We ask that you only remove your mask when you are ready to consume the host and not before or while you are in line. Thank you for your patience and assistance. Please stand.
A voice cries out in the wilderness, make straight a highway for God. People, the dear ones to me, speak to the heart of Jerusalem. The time of your mourning is ended now. The Lord of life will come. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare a way for the Lord. A voice cries out in the wilderness, make straight a highway for God. All flesh is like grass in its flowers. The grass may wither, the flowers may fade, but the word of the Lord is forever. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare a way for the Lord. A voice cries out in the wilderness, make straight a highway for God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends in Christ, on this second Sunday of Advent, our attention is turned to the great figure of John the Baptist. John calls out in the desert, proclaiming a time of repentance and renewal, for the day of the Lord is at hand. As we light two candles on this Advent wreath, let us prepare ourselves through prayer and penance. Let us open a way for the Lord to come into our lives. Before we celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us be alert to the advent of our God and prepare the Lord's way by turning from our sins.
You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You come to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Let us pray. Almighty, merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort. Give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end, her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in. Every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain. The rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up upon a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense for him. Like a sheep, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers his lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord. A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord, one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that you should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by fire, and the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of person ought you to be, conducting yourselves in the holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire? But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him. At peace. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
Yes.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way. A voice of one crying out in the desert, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths.'" John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. People of the whole Judean countryside and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River, as they acknowledged their sins. John was clothed in camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locusts and wild honey, and this is what he proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
If somebody has you, what is Advent for you? What would be your answer? We know what Advent is for the church. We know what Advent is for the church and the calendar of the church and for those who believe. But what is Advent for you as an individual? What is it? Is it another season that comes and goes? Is it another season that we have to change the colors in the church? What is Advent for you? But today we hear from our first reading the prophet proclaiming, "Comfort my people, console my people." Why should the people of God be comforted? It's because the hope that they had for the coming of the Messiah is becoming real, is becoming a reality. That he who was promised is coming. That the people should be comforted because the Messiah is on his way. We are being comforted, but at the same time, we are being invited to change. After being comforted that he is coming, however, you have to change for him to come. We are being invited to change, to be actively watchful and waiting for him. And being actively watchful and waiting for him is to start to clear the path of our righteousness, to clear the hurdles on the path of our righteousness, to clear the mountains in our lives, to fill the potholes of sin in our lives, to level the ground that when he comes, we are ready for him. We are being comforted and consoled because our hope for change is real. He is coming to make it real. He is coming to change. He is coming with a great help to sustain us in our righteous path to eternity. It is our time in Advent to clear the baggage of sin. It is a season when we are being invited to be transformed, to be configured, to be conformed into the life of Christ. Advent is not just a season of changing colors and omitting the Gloria in our sacrifices of Mass, but it's a call for interior renewal, to renew our interior life, our inner life, to become authentic with who we are in order to be authentic heralds of the good news of Christ, facing ourselves, being real with who we are, in order for us to become modern day John the Baptist. John the Baptist knew who he was. He understood who he was. He understood his weaknesses. He understood his humanity. That's why he said, "He is coming after me, and I'm not worthy to untie his sandals." He acknowledged his human weakness, but he knew he is coming to dignify him. Christ Jesus is coming to dignify his humanity. He says, "I'm not worthy that I should untie his sandals." Advent is a season for renewal, a season for transformation, a season for change, a season in which we are being invited into battle, into war, against distortion of truth, war against relativism, a battle against selfishness, a war against self-centeredness, a war against egocentric lifestyles, a battle and war against the culture of death. There are so many deaths in the world today. There are so many of us who are busy killing the hopes of other people. There are some of us in the world today very busy killing the peace of other people. In the world today, there are those who are killing people's happiness. There is death of positivism. There is death of optimism. There is death of belief. There is a culture of death. The death of God. We have killed God in our midst. There are a lot of deaths taking place. We are being invited into war against this culture of death. It is a season when we are called to change for the better, to change for the glory of God. But however, we have to agree that change is not easy. Any change is difficult, but it's not impossible. Change is difficult. Sometimes change is painful. Sometimes change seems to be impossible in many ways, but it is achievable. Change is achievable when we become honest with ourselves. Change is achievable when we are true to ourselves, when we do not lie to ourselves, when we face our truth, when we make in all honesty necessary adjustments towards being a better person. And now our Lord is calling us to make such adjustments in our life of faith, to change. Changes come with acceptance of our human nature. Changes come when we embrace our humanness and be consoled that He is coming, who will enable that change in our lives, Christ the Lord, who is going to change us, who is going to transform us, who is going to conform us into Him, that we may become little and small messiahs for others who still are in unbelief. Advent is not a time to grieve over past mistakes and sins. It is not a season to pity ourselves for who we have been, how messy our life has been. That's not the reason that we have Advent. It is not the time to grieve, to groan, to mourn, to pity ourselves for the past sins, but a time to embrace the sacrament of grace, forgiveness, and love of God. To come to reconcile with Him. A time to care for who we are. A time to understand that our Lord is already here with us. The one we are waiting for is the one who is always blessing us in each and every day. Advent is a time to pray for the grace of God to sustain us in our path of righteousness, to be more fervent in prayer, and ask for the grace of God to sustain us in that journey, that we may not go back to who we were, not to become our past, but to embrace our future. Advent is a time we are invited to become heralds of the good news, to declare, like John the Baptist, to the world the presence of Jesus, the presence of Christ, the presence of our Savior, the presence of our Redeemer. A time to stand and behold, to be counted and say, behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world, who takes away my sins. Behold Him who has redeemed me. Behold Him who has delivered me from sin. A moment to embrace Christ in fullness. A moment to embrace our faith in its entirety, that we do not groan of the past, but we embrace our future in Christ. Few things to remember. I started by asking a question: what is Advent for you? Did you ever answer that question? Advent must have a meaning for you as an individual, for you as an individual Christian. What is Advent for you? Is it just another season or a moment of transformation? Things to remember. Advent is a time and moment of change. That's point number one. A time, moment of change and transformation. Point number one. Point number two. Advent is not a time to grieve over past mistakes. It's not a time to groan over past sins. It is not the time to pity ourselves of the past mistakes and the sins we have committed, but a time to embrace the sacrament of reconciliation, to reconcile with God. That's point number. Point number three. Advent is a time we embrace our future salvation. Advent is a time we embrace our future salvation. Point number four. Advent is a time to pray for the grace of God to sustain us in our path of righteousness. That's point number. A time to pray for the grace of God to sustain us in our path of righteousness. That's what we are called to do. That's point number five. Advent, for those who use computer, is a time to delete and empty the dustbin of sin. Hello? Don't just delete. Delete the file of sin, follow it in the dustbin, and empty it. Because it's very easy to go to the dustbin and bring it back. Delete the file of sin and empty the dustbin. That's point number. So you have to go through the files of your life. Find the one you don't want, delete, follow it, empty. Delete, follow, empty. Delete, follow, empty. Maybe my file is found in my bedroom. I will have to look for it. Delete it and empty it. Hello? Maybe my file of sin is usually in the sitting room. I follow it, delete, and that means Advent is a season to take stock of our faith. That's the conclusion of our sermon today. Advent is a season to take stock of our faith. What we need, we keep. What we don't need, delete, empty. Forget everything, but remember, delete, empty. Don't leave it in the dustbin. You can bring it back. Delete, follow it, and Advent season to take stock of our faith. Be serious in taking stock. I was taking stock myself, and I found so many things. I've deleted some. I am going to empty some of them. It's a season to take stock of our faith, and seriously do so as we prepare for the coming of our Lord. We fill those potholes
we flatten the mountains. Maybe my sin is a mountain I have to flatten. Maybe yours is a pothole, you have to fill it. What is Advent for you? Work on it as we await the celebration of the birth of Christ.
I believe in one God, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before the ages, God from God, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For us, and rose again in the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. As we prepare our hearts and lives for the day the Lord comes, let us call to mind our needs and the needs of the world around us.
For the Church, that we may make straight the Lord's path, allowing his presence to permeate our lives and the lives of people around the world, especially those desperate for comfort and hope, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may listen to the voices crying out in the desert, the voices of those who hunger and thirst for sustenance, justice, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer with the coronavirus and for their families, caretakers and medical staff, may God spare them suffering and bring them healing and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
For continued blessings on those retired religious we remember today, may we be generous to the sisters, brothers, and priests who have worked tirelessly for the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish may grow in grace through the season of Advent as we prepare to greet the Lord Jesus when he returns. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have asked for our prayers, for those whose names are written in our prayer request book, and for those who have died this week, Gilbert C. Orozco Sr., Ernest Cardona, Tricia Morris, Martha Rose Estrada, Christopher Broglie, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the special intentions of this Mass, for the eternal repose of Paul Carriger, Marjorie Eckert, Blanca Contreras, and for the soon recovery of Father Antonio Moreno, that he may recover soon from coronavirus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Almighty Father, as we look forward to the coming of your Son, Fill us with your mercy and answer our prayers. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. Say to the cities of Judah, prepare the way of the mountain top, lift your voice, Jerusalem, here is your God. Like a shepherd he feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. I myself will shepherd them, for others have led them astray. The lost I will rescue and heal their wounds and pasture them, giving them rest. Like a shepherd feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim: Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love, for you formed man in your own image, and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again, you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to the prisoners freedom, to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, and as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ for the celebration of this great mystery which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread. He blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Franz of Pope, Gustav of Bishop, the order of bishops, and all the clergy, those who partake in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom, there with the whole creation freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And now together, let us pray to the Father. in the words our Savior taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptations,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Look beyond the bread you eat. See your Savior as your Lord. Look beyond the cup you drink. See his love poured out his blood. Give us a sign that we
And now, together with our brothers and sisters unable to receive the body of Christ, let us make a spiritual communion with them. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Those who eat this bread will never die. see his love poured out his blood. This man speaks harshly, who can listen to his words? We shall no longer follow him. Look beyond the bread you eat. See your Savior as your Lord. Look beyond the cup you drink. See his love poured out his blood. You, my disciples, will you also leave? Lord, to whom can we go? Look beyond the bread you eat. See your Savior as your Lord. Look beyond the cup you drink. See his love poured out his blood.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Together with our Mary, or with our Mother Mary, we pray. Our Lady of Guadalupe, in these times of tribulation, we turn to you, O Mother. See with compassion the suffering of your beloved sons and daughters affected by the coronavirus throughout the entire world. Ask your Son to have mercy on us, bringing healing to those infected and protection to all your children. Jesus Christ, Savior of all people, grant us courage to accompany and care for the entire world in the wake of sorrow and uncertainty. Seek refuge in you, and according to your promise, deliver us, Lord, from this danger. Amen. Saint Antony of Padua, pray for us. You may be seated for a while.
The second collection this weekend is for retired religious men and women. In good times and bad, senior Catholic sisters, brothers, and religious order priests have dedicated themselves to service and acts of mercy. Today, they pray for an aching world. Yet, years of serving for little or no pay have left their religious communities without enough retirement savings. Your gift to this retirement fund for religious helps provide medications, nursing care, and other necessities. Thank you for your generosity. This Tuesday, December the 8th, is the Feast of the Immaculate Conception, a holy day of obligation. Vigil Mass will be on Monday, December the 7th at 6:30. It will be bilingual. And on Tuesday, December the 8th at 12 noon, the church office will be closed. The St. Luke angel tree is set up in our church foyer. There are still some angels and snowmen representing the families in our vicinity and elderly citizens in our nearby nursing homes that could use our help this season. Please pick up an angel or a snowman. We will then provide gift cards to our angel tree families. Please contact the Faith Formation Office for more information. Thank you for your generosity to those in need during these trying times. Advent Reconciliation will be held on Monday, December the 7th from 10:30 to 12 noon, and on Wednesday, December the 9th from 6 to 8 p.m. The Guadalupano Ministry will be set up in the church foyer this weekend, accepting donations to help purchase roses for Our Lady of Guadalupe Feast Day. Pledges and donations for the Our Lady of Guadalupe Walkathon will also be accepted. On December the 12th, Mañanitas will begin at 6 a.m. and Mass at 7 a.m. The Bethlehem Nativity Group will be at St. Luke on December the 12th and 13th after all Masses, selling beautiful olive wood carvings from the Holy Land. For centuries, the Christians in and around Bethlehem have earned a living by carving religious olive wood art to sell to visiting pilgrims. Bethlehem Nativity Groups helps the struggling Christian families of Bethlehem by marketing their artwork in the United States. Your purchase will make a difference in the lives of many Christian families. Please follow the usher's exiting instructions. Each section will be exiting by pew and in a specific direction to allow for social distancing and easier exit. Now we invite new parishioners or visitors that we may have here at the church at this time to please stand up if we have visitors. No, we don't. Okay, you one visitor? Where are you coming from?
Very nice.
Okay, very good. Now, do we have anyone celebrating anniversary or birthday?
There they are.
One lady. Anyone else? Birthday, right? Okay. Well, let's give her a blessing. Almighty Father, bless this child of you and guide her during all her life so she can clear the path for righteousness, so she can go all the way to your eternal glory. For Christ our Lord, amen. Let's give her a round of applause. Congratulations.
You two at the back, you were saying, it's only that we could not see very clearly. Thank you, and live long to enjoy life. Those who are celebrating birthdays, those who have anniversary to come, live life to the full, include Christ in that life. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let's go in peace to announce the gospel of the Lord.
Awake from your slumber. sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned